Bloodstripe is a movie about a female sergeant in the military who returns after her third tour and finds herself struggling with PTSD.
I think we need to get you to the VA.
There's a wait.
The film is now available on video demand services such as iTunes, Amazon. For more this morning, so happy to be joined by the movie's co-writer and star, Kate Nowlin, and Allison Jaslow, an Army veteran and executive director of the Iraq and Afghanistan Veterans of America. Thank you both for joining me.
Thanks for having us.
Sure. Let's start with that wait for help. In the movie, you're told it's 129 days. You're going minute to minute here, or if not second by second, yes, in the state you're in.
Indeed, and that was a number that was researched, and we can back up, and I believe it's around that same period of time, depending on the state where you reside. And so, yeah, we felt as writers and producers, and then, of course, playing the role, we needed to accurately represent some of the average wait time that some of our veterans are waiting to receive the care that they need.
Kate, how much did you rely on Allison for the film? And then kind of both. I mean, I'm wondering, how involved were you and how involved did you want to be with Kate?
We actually only met after once the film was completed.
So there was no introduction beforehand?
No, it's an uncanny sort of meeting, but we were following the work that Allison was doing at IAVA, right, and reached out to them once the film was completed.
So when you see the film, is it an accurate portrayal, you think, of what female vets are going through on the return home?
So I think the most important thing for you all to know and for all of your viewers is that every veteran's experience is different. And one of the reasons why, you know, we're partnering with the filmmakers on this is because not enough awareness is out there of issues and the unique issues of women veterans. In fact, women veterans, when it compared to civilian women, are dying by suicide at the rate of 250% of civilian women. And it's, people aren't talking enough about that. People aren't talking enough and seeing enough women veterans out there, and that is sort of what the gift is of this film.
We were interested, once we had completed filming and we were following the work of IAVA and a few other veteran organizations, because we knew we wanted to partner up with the film to not only create a film and release it theatrically for people to see and go to the movie theater and have a movie-going experience, but to also try to create some impact in the space and see if we can help create more conversation around areas of reform. Allison, they had just recently launched a campaign called She Who Born the Battle to raise awareness around our female veterans and potentially improve some of the care they're receiving upon their homecoming, and so it was it's been a very good fit.
And Kate, we only know your character as our sergeant.
Yeah.
I'm guessing that's purposeful, because she really couldn't be anyone who has served.
That was the idea. We wanted her to sort of stand in that kind of iconic warrior figure. You know, Clint Eastwood did it, like with The Man with No Name, and sort of just like that iconic figure, feminizing the warrior archetype a little bit. And just sort of having her stand in a way that a lot of people can project their own experiences, maybe their own personal connection or family member who serves and whose name and story they can apply to
and
her.
There's really no flashbacks in the film. I mean, we see the scars.
That's right.
We don't know exactly what took place.
It's really a meditation and a study on how these people, we can help these people come home. Some of our veterans carrying certain wounds, how we can help them come home and transition. So we were less interested in talking about the war, I guess, and recreating images we all carry as a culture and our consciousness, and more interested in sort of the study of the impact of war, and how we can help facilitate that transition back into civilian life for some of these veterans.
There's some silent moments in the film, and I'm wondering, Allison, because, you know, sometimes silence is powerful, just as much dialogue in movies, but did you have silent moments when you come back from war, and are those important moments that people around you need to realize and say, we need to talk? Maybe not with you personally, but those you served with as well?
So I'd say two things. One, first of all, I think we were dancing around it here, but the reality is that you don't think of a woman who looks like me when you think of a veteran. And so that's something that I believe is also communicated in this film, and that's helpful for the public to learn through pop culture and through art. But the other thing is, you know, you don't realize what war has done to you when you're over there, how you've adapted, the coping skills.
Till you
get home.
Yeah.
And everybody's experience and transition back is different. I mean, Vietnam War vets who are learning about their PTSD 20 years later. But simple things like, you know, driving down the street in Baghdad, you're looking for trash and for cans that could potentially be IEDs or improvised explosive devices, roadside bombs. And once you become hypervigilant like that, you come back and you drive on American roads looking for that all the time. It takes a while for it to wear off. And those are just things people don't think about.
Can you give those of us who might see your movie and think, I could have been a better citizen? I think we all say, if I were to see you in uniform, let's say sitting next to me on BART, I'd say thank you for your service. How can we go beyond that?
I think if I would tell anybody who asked me that question, it's take it one step further. Unfortunately, the civilian-military divide is such today that a lot of people aren't connected to those of us who are carrying the burden of 16 years of war. And take it one step further and learn to value our experience. Learn a little bit, understand about like the sacrifice not only of myself, but of my mom, who was sick to her stomach every single night, not knowing I knew if I was in danger more so than my mom did. But if we can challenge ourselves, I think, as a nation, to really understand the experience of those who are serving and their families, I think we'd be much better off.
And maybe when we close our eyes, only to add to what Allison is saying, when we close our eyes and we think of some of the people serving for overseas and this our longest war, that we close our eyes, we also see a woman, that our warriors are women.
Yeah.
And that's an important thing, that they feel recognized for their service and sacrifice as well. As our servicemen.
Agreed. Kate Nowlin, Allison Jaslow, the movie is Bloodstripe. Thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations. Thank you for your service.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.